An important topic is the use of poison by the BND. It is known that in the past, persons purposely had been encouraged by snitches to drink. Allegedly, this was done to make them talk. One has to assume that in today's Germany, the whole illegal drugs trading takes place under the surveillance and governance of the secret services. The German secret services deliberately supply targeted persons with drugs to harm them and make them addicted to legal or illegal drugs. The brainwashing, steering and mood management techniques described elsewhere on my homepage and in my films are employed to enforce the use of drugs by persons being regarded as enemies of the totalitarian state. But if a dealer sells drugs to the wrong persons, he's in big trouble. Often the victims of torture by the totalitarian German state, on top of that, are being punished for taking drugs. According to publications, the law enforcement agencies are only allowed to act against the Nazis within the German secret services when they are authorized by the Ministry of the Interior. Such an authorization was not even granted in a case in which one person was left dead. This would create an enormous scandal in every country, except for Germany. In November 2007 surfaced that officials of the Verfassungsschutz had warned one of their snitchers that a wiretapping by the police was going on. This snitcher had delivered guns to right-wing extremists. With one of these guns, a person was shot dead during a robbery. In this particular case, the investigation is halted because the Ministry of the Interior in Düsseldorf did not grant an authorization to investigate the betrayal of official secrets by the officials of the Verfassungsschutz. According to foreign publication, the BND had been established to control Germans and their descendants abroad. Germans and their descendants abroad had been, in 1946, the persons who had fled the persecution by the Gestapo. And of course the survivors of the concentration camps and prisons, who had left Germany either because they were foreigners or because they did not want to live any longer in Germany. Most of the BND officials had been the offenders of the Third Reich. Of course, they used all possible means to covertly silence their victims. It is obvious that the Nazi secret service BND systematically used poisons which did not kill, but instead heavily damaged the health of the targeted individuals during years and decades, with the aim to neutralize them. Important evidence is found in Examination of Norwegian Ex-Concentration Camp Prisoners, which was published by Axel Ström in 1962. In early 1957, a medical screening of former Norwegian political prisoners in Germany was started, because at this time, a considerable part of them was unable to work or live a normal life. Most remarkable is that the number of persons affected was rising at this time. Former prisoners had, as one would expect, recovered well immediately after their liberation. They had lived a normal life. But more than 10 years after their liberation, they developed symptoms of breakdown despite no recent damaging mechanisms were identified. Their medical condition was named concentration camp syndrome. Of the affected, 81 out of 100 complained about increased fatigue, 74 about nervousness, and 73 about decreasing memory and the inability to concentrate. Many of the former political prisoners experienced premature aging. Considerable shrinkage of areas of the brain was seen in many radiographs of the affected Gestapo victims. As the political prisoners had recovered within a short time after their liberation, one has to agree to the only possible conclusion. They had been victims of a well-coordinated, covert poisoning of as many former political prisoners as possible to silence them. This poisoning may have been started as early as 1946 or 1947 by the former SS and Gestapo personnel who had established the organization Gehlen, which later was renamed BND. The BND officials obviously used their net of snitches which they had organized during the occupation. Members of my family had told me how they had been openly persecuted abroad by the BND in 1958. This persecution was carried out during many weeks without any identifiable reason. One reason seems to have been to keep the local authorities busy and to divert them from other concealed operations. Primarily, poisons being effective over weeks or months will have been used to reduce the necessary effort. This consideration points to substances which, like THC, the active component of marijuana, are accumulated in the fatty tissue of the body. It takes several weeks to eliminate THC from the body. Another requirement would be a large range between effective and lethal dose, as conspicuous death may lead to investigation. Certainly many different ways to poison the former political prisoners had been used, including gassing on the street by letting the victim walk into a cloud of dust or aerosol. Even today, the German secret services may use poisons abroad, although laser and microwaves are usually being used. I had read in a publication from the 1980s that the Verfassungsschutz was buying hundreds of kilograms of psychopharmaceutical drugs. Which poisons may have been used can easily be ascertained through evaluation of the literature on toxicology. References can be found in Lehrbuch der Militärchemie, published by Siegfried Franke in East Berlin, 1977. The described premature aging, of course, would lead to earlier death and accordingly must be classified as murder. After the BND had assassinated my brother, there can be no doubt that the BND also directly assassinated former political prisoners of the Third Reich. The case of the former SS member John Demjanjuk having deliberately overrun and killed a Jew with a truck in 1947 recently was reported in the media. The book Psychiatrie der Verfolgten, in English that would read Psychiatry of the Persecuted, a 400 pages German publication from 1964 by Walter Ritter von Bayer, refers to the publication of Ström. It states on page 76 that 12 years after the liberation, the former political prisoners still were suffering social and medical damages. This is quite contrary to the important finding of Ström, who described recovery within a few weeks, normal life during many years, and then massive neurological damage. This is obviously a deliberate cover-up of the very remarkable findings of Ström to prevent further discussion of the matter. This book also documents many cases of open persecution of former political prisoners and victims of racial hatred. All of these victims of open persecution by the Gestapo, Organisation Gehlen and BND are defamed as paranoid, schizophrenic and the like. Walter Ritter von Bayer in 1972 was decorated with the Bundesverdienstkreuz.